I'm Donna Villa of Shalom World, bringing you the news from around the globe. Franciscan brother Peter Mokaya Tabichi has been named Person of the Year by the United Nations in Kenya for his contribution in the field of education. Brother Peter Mokaya Tabichi received the award during the United Nations Day celebration in Nairobi. Tabichi reminded that about 6 million girls of school age around the world, the majority of them in Africa, do not have the opportunity to attend classes. Peter Tabichi said that the role of education should be to unlock the best in people and in giving them the ability and skills to be able to relate and connect with others in society. In the Pope video for the month of November, Pope Francis urged Catholics to pray for dialogue and reconciliation in the Middle East. The Holy Father reminded that the good news of Jesus, risen out of love, came to us from that place. Father Frédéric Fornos, International Director of the Pope's Worldwide Prayer Network, said Pope Francis is inviting us this month to open our hearts and our prayers to the Middle East. Middle East is the land where the three great monotheistic religions were born. It's the land of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the land of the prophets, and where Jesus was born of Mary. The church was born there. The Christian community represents approximately 5% of the region's population. The Pope video is an official global initiative to disseminate the Holy Father's monthly intentions. It is carried out by the Pope's Worldwide Prayer Network. The Catholic Church in Australia is dedicating the month of November 2019 to pray for those affected by crippling drought conditions and to pray for the gift of rain. A national prayer campaign has been organized across the country by the Bishops' Conference. Assistance and all kinds of aid to support those who are affected by the drought are also encouraged. Bishop Columba Macbeth Green of Wilcannia Forbes, whose diocese covers about half of the state and includes some of the most drought-affected areas in the country, said that the month of prayer was an additional response to the local work being done in affected communities.
I implore you to keep those people in your prayers, whole families, whole communities, and by God's grace, that His healing touch will help them to persevere through this most difficult of times.
In his message, Bishop Columba said that praying for rain shows our humility. The European Court of Human Rights urged Switzerland not to deport an Afghani Christian convert back to his home country. Faith-based legal advocacy organization ADF International, which intervened in the case, said that the person would face severe persecution if deported back to Afghanistan. Robert Clark, director of the European Advocacy for ADF International, said, "Our society has a responsibility to protect those who are facing torture, imprisonment, or death due to their religious beliefs. Afghanistan counts as one of the most dangerous countries in the world for Christians and, in particular, for converts." ADF International's intervention sought to highlight the severe breaches of human rights in Afghanistan against religious minorities, and especially the widespread persecution of Christians. Chinese government has offered land to the Wugaozhang parishioners as compensation for the church that was demolished recently. A church in Wugaozhang, located in part of Hubei's Quanto district, was demolished by Chinese authorities last week. The church was built on farmland that the parishioners had purchased since their old church could not accommodate people because of their growing congregation. There were widespread and intense protests against the government decision to demolish the church. After several hours of negotiations, the Chinese government has agreed to provide a piece of land to rebuild the church somewhere else, as well as money to compensate for the destruction of the original building. Thanks for watching and for your support. Stay in touch on social media, our app, and online at shalomworld.org. May you walk in the light of the Lord, and may peace.